He's held court with a pope and received praise from an American president.
You're contributing to the promotion of the ideals of tolerance and interfaith dialogue, inspired by Fethullah Gulen.
Fethullah Gulen's story takes him from a small town in Turkey to founder of a multi-billion dollar Islamic movement bearing his name. Despite a grade school level education, this Turkish imam leads a worldwide following of some 5 million devotees. They refer to him as Hoca Effendi, or master teacher.
What is the end goal of this movement, which constitute multi-billion dollar of a budget?
That's a question many are asking. Gulen claims to represent a moderate brand of Islam that is compatible with the modern world. It emphasizes interfaith dialogue and the pursuit of science. Yet one expert told CBN News there's much more to the story.
It's not just a religious movement. It's Fethullah Gulen movement. They call themselves that. So it is, you can say, a cult. You can say a highly personalized movement.
Middle East analyst Ariel Cohen tracks the Gulen movement closely.
What he's talking about is not the caliphate, is not the Sharia state. He calls it the new world Islamic order.
Cohen says some in the U.S. government and academia support reaching out to Gulen's followers as a way to counter al-Qaeda and other jihadist groups.
The idea being, and just like people who say we should have a good relationship with Muslim Brotherhood, the idea is that these are mainstream Islamists.
Critics claim Gulen wants Islam to play a more active role in societies, breaking down barriers between mosque and state, while also promoting Turkish nationalism and identity.
This is the global headquarters of the Fethullah Gulen movement. Gulen himself lives here, over 25 spacious acres. But this isn't Istanbul or Ankara. This is rural Pennsylvania, in the heart of the Pocono Mountains.
The Golden Generation Worship and Retreat Center sounds like a ski lodge and looks the part. CBN News toured the compound with a staffer, but we were not permitted to film or meet Fethullah Gulen. The 70-year-old leader is in poor health and rarely gives interviews. He came to America in 1998, reportedly to seek medical treatment. Since then, he's directed his global empire from Pennsylvania. A federal judge granted him a green card in 2008. Shortly after he left for America, a series of secretly recorded sermons featuring Gulen aired on Turkish television. In one of them, he told his followers, "You must move in the arteries of the system without anyone noticing your existence until you reach all the power centers. You must wait for the time when you are complete and conditions are ripe until we can shoulder the entire world and carry it. You must wait until such time as you have gotten all the state power, until you have brought to your side all the power of the constitutional institutions in Turkey." After the tapes aired, Turkish authorities indicted Gulen on charges that he was plotting to overthrow the secular government of Turkey. The charges were eventually dropped, and the Gulen movement continues to expand its influence through the construction of schools worldwide, including in America.
There's about 125 Gulen charter schools spread out across 25 states. This Gulen school in Philadelphia receives $3 million annually in taxpayer money.
They work through the education system. Their main tool is educating kids.
Gulen charter schools have nondescript names like True Bright Science Academy and focus heavily on math and science. Many of the teachers hail from Turkey. Federal authorities are reportedly investigating whether some employees kick back a portion of their salaries to the Gulen movement. Classified documents released by WikiLeaks show that U.S. officials have concerns about the Gulen schools. The U.S. Embassy in Ankara stated, "We have multiple reliable reports that the Gulenists use their school network, including dozens of schools in the U.S., to cherry-pick students they think are susceptible to being molded as proselytizers. And we have steadily heard reports about how the schools indoctrinate boarding students." Meanwhile, in its birthplace of Turkey, the movement continues to grow. Gulenists are said to make up at least 70% of the federal police force, devoted to their master teacher half a world away in the Pocono Mountains. Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News, Sailorsburg, Pennsylvania.